That's Money Brown, man. Harrison, Jr. What Money Brown? He get a lot of money, so I call him Money Brown.
What's good, Money Brown TV? What up, what up?
Yeah.
I just want to give a shout out to Money Brown TV. Thank you so much for everything. Hey, it's Ryan Garcia here. Shout out to Money Brown TV. Thank you so much for
everything.
Yo, what's going on at the fight? Well, it's your boy Money back with another one, man. And this one here is on TV himself, Mr. Money May. We know 5-division world champion, walking legend, future Hall of Famer. About to take on Logan Paul June the 6th. Then we have Javante Tank Davis, 2-division world champion, looking to be a 3-division world champion by taking on none other than Mario Berrios, the 140-pound WBA regular, 140-pound WBA regular world champion. Sorry, y'all. And, Money Mayweather say he's afraid for Tank, bro. He say he's afraid for Tank. You feel me? He know this is a dangerous fight. This is not a fight that he wanted for Tank. This is a fight that Tank picked for himself that a lot of people gonna try to hate on, right? You gotta get Tank credit. When you look at the overall landscape, right? He supposed to fight Ryan Garcia. Ryan Garcia pulled out because he thought he had the Manny Pacquiao fight. Excuse me. We see what Ryan Garcia doing at the moment. Devin Haney had a contract signed to fight Poirier Lenores, but we know he was trying to fight Teofimo Lopez. Teofimo Lopez had himself a mandatory with fucking George Kambosos. And when you look at the 130-pound division, you know, it was a few fights that was very entertaining that he could have made happen. But nonetheless, you know, Javante Davis picked Mario Berrios, and I'm not pissed off at the fight. I'm not mad at the fight because I know what Mario Berrios is. I know he fit right in with those guys at 130 and those guys at 135. Right, his popularity probably not as high as those dudes, but when we talking about San Antonio, Texas, they fuck with this guy right here, Mario Berrios. They stands up for Mario Berrios. You feel me? Tank fought in San Antonio, Texas, when he fought Leo Santa Cruz, if I'm not mistaken. Don't quote me, but Berrios was on the undercard, and they always come out for Berrios. They always come out for Berrios. Every time Berrios fight in Texas, his fans and his family travel. You understand what I'm saying? He's an Aztec warrior. He ride for his people. He's a fucking banger, and you cannot just discredit him. You cannot just discredit him. Like I say, he is a WBA regular world champion, whether you like it or not. Whether you like it or not. And Berrios is coming to fight. He's coming to fight. A lot of people picking out the fight where they thought he lost this, that, and third. But listen, man, he got the W. He got the W. He went in there. He beat Cowboy, right? He beat Cowboy. So he got that win. You can't take that away from him. Ryan Carr, Cowboy, right? And now he got a Javante Davis fight. You know what I mean? And he go coming on, and he's not laying down. He's not looking to be no pushover, shit like that. He understand what this kid is, right? Javante Davis. He understand the star power, the skill set, the power, right? But he's not worrying about none of that shit. He don't give a fuck about that. You know, Berrios is coming to fight. And Tank is coming to fight as well. That's why Tank picked this fight. Tank knew it was a dangerous fight. He knew it's a tall, rangy, long fighter. And Tank, when he said he wanted to fight at 140, like I said, some people thought he was crazy. When Tank said he'd knock out Josh Taylor, some people thought he was crazy. You understand what I'm saying? When you say he'll beat Regis Prograis, some people thought he was crazy. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, you got to be crazy to be a fucking boxer. You got to be crazy to get punched in the face for a living. A brain ain't made to be shook, and a body ain't made to be beat on, homie. Do your research. I'm going to say it again. Your brain ain't made to be shook, and a body is not made to be beat on. You feel me? But Javante Davis, he's going in that ring. He's facing, you know, Mario Berrios, and it's a dangerous fight. It's a dangerous fight. For Floyd to come out and say he's a little nervous, things of that nature. For Leonard Ellerbe to come out and say they was nervous, this wasn't a pick for them. You gotta get Tank credit. You heard Tank say it's over. You understand me? He was feeling good this night, going up against Jose Pedraza and winning that scrap to become a world champion at 130 pounds. But nonetheless, right? You gotta be a little nervous for Tank. You know what I'm saying? When you're the promoter, when you're the guys that's advising him, but he telling you, nah, this what I want, this what I want, you gotta make it happen. But you do got to believe in that kid's confidence. You do got to say, you know what? Tank is a bad motherfucker. His skill set is a skill set. His skill set is a skill set. Now, I'm saying a lot of people out here, oh, man, Tank's supposed to knock out Berrios. Tank's supposed to do this. Tank's supposed to... No. Tank got to do it. Supposed ain't no supposed to nothing. You feel me? You got to go out there. You got to perform, bro. You got to be in shape. You got to be ready. You got to be on point. You know what I mean? You got another man from across from you that's trying to knock your damn head off, that throw punches just like you. That hit hard just like you, because Berrios ain't no pillar puncher. You know what I'm saying? He got pop as well. And then he got the reach and the height, bro. Tank is going to have to work his way in the inside, and he's going to have to take some shit to get there. He's going to have to take some shit to get there, you know what I'm saying? And Berrios got a hell of a trainer. So this is going to be one hell of a fight, family. This is going to be one hell of a fight. June is on the way, right? What's today, the 21st? So June is on D-Way. We starting off with Floyd Mayweather and Logan Paul. Should have been Teofimo Lopez and George Kambosos, but we seen Triller, they sprouted out the June 5th date because of Floyd Mayweather. They act like they're afraid of him or some shit. But nonetheless, we starting off with Floyd Mayweather, Jake Paul, and then we're going to move on through June, through that aspect. You know what I mean? A couple pay-per-views to buy, but we're going to make it happen. You know, Monty B going to show you the fights. Nonetheless, we're going to make it happen. But this fight is one hell of a fight. I like this fight. Like I said, it was from left field. Nobody seen this fight coming, right? Nobody seen this fight coming. But Floyd, he don't want to fuck up the money. He don't want to fuck up the money. It's a very, very dangerous fight. You know what I mean? What it say? It's very, very dangerous fucking with Mario Berrios. You know what I mean? People, when you look at certain fighters, people be looking like, oh, man, that fight is just an easy fight. Nah, y'all assume that fight is just an easy fight. What Floyd said about Emmanuel Augustus, that was his toughest fight of his career. Toughest fight of his career, the Drunken Master. Dude was just tough. Mario Berrios is a tough fighter, bro. He's a tough fighter. You're going to have to knock him out to keep him down. You're going to have to knock him out. You're going to have to make him say, well, he ain't going to say no more. You're going to have to put him down and keep him down. Let's just say that. For a man to fight with a swollen face, a swollen eye, things of that nature, you got to respect him. And Berrios is to be respected. You feel me? And that's why I respect Berrios. Because if he going out, he get tank problems. It's a hard-nosed fight. That tank pull out and win that bitch. I'm saying it's because of Mario Berrios, not because the tank went up to 140 and tank, no, he wasn't ready for 140. Tank was small. Nah, it's because Mario Berrios is a hell of a fighter, and I'm going to give him his just due. He fought Tank. He showed that he was on that level. But Tank found a way to win. That's all that matters. You understand me? But if Tank going out, handle his business, do what he got to do, get Berrios out of there, right? You get that credit to Javonte Davis. Say that boy just a bad, bad boy. You feel me? And he's looking to fight the best at the 140-pound division, which may be the win of Taylor Ramirez, Regis Prograis, Mikey Garcia. It's a line of fighters that's at 140, 135, and 130 that Tank can maneuver with. You feel me? But nonetheless, he got Mario Berrios in his, right here in front of him. This is the man he need to worry about. Like Mikey Garcia said, like Leo Santa Cruz said, this is a dangerous fight, bro. This is a dangerous fight. You know, a lot of people don't know Berrios like that. They just think he's just, oh, man, he's just another fighter. You know, Tank cherry picking. Oh, he went to 140 to fight this guy. Why didn't he pick this guy? Why didn't he pick that guy? Well, last time I checked, the two best guys are fighting each other for undisputed, right? They fighting each other for undisputed. And then Regis Prograis just had a fight with fucking, what's the guy name? The boy that faked it. You know what I mean? He faked it, so he just had a fight against him, right? So those are the best fights of the division to me. Mikey about to, he don't know what he gonna do. You know, he's supposed to fight at 147, but he's saying he can fight at 140. So Tank, he made the best decision for him, bro. He made the best decision for him that's going on pay-per-view. A fighter that's a hell of a fighter that you can get in there and give the crowd an action-packed fight that's gonna be fan-friendly that we all gonna like. You know what I'm saying? And this is one of them fights. He's a young fighter. He's undefeated. He's the champion. So what are y'all gonna say? What are y'all gonna say? You feel me? Just give love where love is due, man. Show credit. I mean, give credit where credit is due. Show love where love is due. You know what I mean? This going to be one of them hell of a fights, bro, that we're going to enjoy. You got to enjoy the action-packed fights. You got to enjoy them. Yes, we want Tank and the big guys. We want Tank Devin Haney. We want Tank Ryan Garcia. We want Tank Teofimo. We want Tank, what's my man name? JoJo Diaz. Tank Tevin Former. You know, but not Tank to put the name with Josh Taylor and put his name with Regis Prograis and put his name with Mikey Garcia. More headliners, and that just showed the star power when Javonte Davis. When you can take your name from 130 to 140, bro, let that sink in. You take your name from 130 to 140, and y'all telling me Javonte Davis ain't on the pound for pound list? Hold on, man, something ain't right, family. You can take your name from 130 to 140, bro, and you're not on a pound for pound list? Come on, my brothers and sisters, we got to keep this trail. Pound for pound list is about could you survive in different weight classes, right? Right? Skill sets, wins, titles, undefeated record. Javonte Davis has it all. He has it all, bro. Two division world champion, right? You see him in his third division right now. His third division. You understand what I'm saying? Skill set is crazy. Fighting on pay-per-view. One of the biggest names in the sport. You got to get a kid credit. You got to give him credit. Whether you got him in the top 10 or the lower bottom five, wherever you have him, Tank deserves to be on somebody pound for pound list. And that's just true. That's true. You feel me? If y'all say the competition you fight, well, he fought champions. He fought champions, whether you like it or not. Four division world champions. You know what I'm saying? World champions. Like, you got to get a man his credit. You got to give him his credit. Now he's facing another champion in Mario Berrios, looking to be a three-division world champion. You have to get credit where credit is due, family. You have to. You just have to. You feel me? But I feel Floyd Mayweather when you say he feel a little nervous for this fight. It's that kind of fight. It's that kind of fight. If Tank get careless and Berrios hit his ass with the right shot, could he put Tank down? Could he swell an eye? Could he break a motherfucking jawbone? Could he punch her a rib? Could he do something that can hurt Gervonta Davis and fuck around and spoil the apple court? You know, anything can happen in boxing. We just don't know, bro. Anything can happen in boxing. You feel me? This is the game of the unknown. It's a masterful class game that you got to master, but it's still the game of the unknown. You feel me? Berrios can come out there, punch Tank in the eye with the first fucking punch and swell this shit up. And now Tank got to deal with that adversity. You never know how this fight game go, bro. You never know. You feel me? We seen the Riverside Rocky, Jose Cito Lopez break Victor Ortiz's jaw after he was winning the damn fight, plus the fight Canelo Alvarez. We seen things like that, bro. We seen Mickey Bay get knocked out in the 12th round when he was winning a whole damn fight against John Molina. We seen things like that, bro. Come on now. Anything can happen in boxing, dog. Anything can happen in boxing. Ryan Burnett was beating Nonito Donaire's ass and twisted his fucking back and fucked up something in his back, and Nonito Donaire became the world champion. We seen things like that, bro. Anything can happen in the sport of boxing. You just don't know. That's why it's the game of the unknown, but you got to keep your faith. You got to keep your eyes on the prize, and you got to go for your guy. You feel me? I still believe Gervonta Davis will be victorious in this fight, right? Do Tank have a chance to knock out Berrios? Yes, he will have a chance to knock out Berrios because these dudes are going to fight, right? I think Tank do hit harder, but I think Berrios hit hard as well. That dude is the bigger guy. He's tall, he's rangy, and he ain't no bitch. He ain't no bitch. So this is going to be one hell of a fight, man. I feel Floyd Money Mayweather when he say he's nervous. I feel in the LB when he says he's nervous. I respect Tank for taking this fight. It is a step-up fight. I'm happy people, you know, some people that say they want to give him credit turning around and saying, you know what, you got to think about it. He is the bigger, longer fighter. So we say Tank fights small fighters, now he's fighting bigger fighters. So you got to give a man his credit, bro. You got to give him his credit. So we'll just see how the fight play out. It's going to be one hell of a fight. Like I say, June 26th on pay-per-view. Make sure y'all support, show love, because it's going to be a hell of a night. It's going to be a hell of a night, and we're all going to enjoy it. But we will see what happens. Until then, shouts out to Floyd Money Mayweather. Good luck on June the 6th. Shouts out to Tank. Good luck June 26th. Shouts out to Berrios. Good luck June 26th. And we'll see how it play out, and we can talk about it after that. Until then, it's your boy Money. It's the NSBC. Moving and everybody safe in these streets. Hit them thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. If you want to donate, OG Money on Cash App. TreyHampton52@gmail.com on PayPal. If not, just tell a friend. Hit the subscribe button. Like, comment, share the video. And y'all know how your boy get down. Big dog status, family.